Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a simple block swapper that swaps out a 3x3 donut shape that is one above the floor. So the entire thing is lever controlled, and you can see when I flick the lever, I now have a completely different donut, and if I flick the lever again, I am back to my first donut again. So that's basically what this contraption here does. Now, with that out of the way, let's talk about the sizes. So in total, it's 15 blocks wide, 7 blocks long, and has a depth of 5 blocks below the floor, although in the lowest layer there are only 2 blocks. Unfortunately, there is no way to really get rid of those two. So basically, that's the sizes. Now with that out of the way, let's talk about the required resources. So to build this, you're gonna need building blocks and obviously the blocks for the donuts themselves, which can be full blocks, but they can also be transparent blocks like layers and slabs and similar. Then for redstone components, it's 35 redstone dust, a single redstone torch, 18 repeaters, 18 observers, 18 sticky pistons and 18 normal pistons, and then a single lever. And with that out of the way, let me show you how to build this block swapper here. Start by placing a 5x5 ring with a central block in the floor. This is basically making this 3x3 donut in the middle where the blocks can be moved through. From the central block, then go 4 blocks down. We only need the fourth one of those blocks and put redstone dust on top. Towards the front, then we need 2 lowered blocks, one with redstone dust and the other with a repeater on 4 ticks on top. Now place 8 sticky pistons in a circle around the redstone wire. And then, let's go on the top here, place another circle of sticky pistons on top of that one. Then while we're here, place an observer inside of this middle here on top of the wire. Just make sure that the wire remains in the cross shape. And then a full block on top. Now let's go down here. And here we start with a rectangle of blocks around the lower edge, you could say, of the sticky pistons, but with a 1 wide gap towards the front and the back. Put redstone dust on top. Then blocks in those 2 corners here with repeaters on 4 ticks each running into the lower pistons. The same at the back here. Then we need observers on top of those repeaters, topped with full blocks. Same on the front side. Then at the middle of the build, towards the left, a block with redstone wire, and the same at the right side. Now at the front, place 4 normal blocks, as you can see here, and then an observer powering downwards in between, like so. Put a repeater on 4 ticks each on those 2 blocks going outwards, and then some redstone dust in the middle. This will be our input, so for now let's just place a block on top with a lever. And then on the right side, let's start with a block with a torch on the side. Then hovering below, we need a block with redstone dust. It should be powered by the torch. Then another block here with a repeater on 4 ticks, running into a block on top of a sticky piston. Then following that, another block with a 4 tick repeater. This runs into a full block with a lowered block towards the back. Then we need to go 1 layer down and add 3 blocks to this row. Place 4 redstone wire, observers on the last 3, then observers looking at them from the side, run them into full blocks. Then we have 3 lowered full blocks and then another 3 raised full blocks. Put down 3 repeaters on 2 ticks each in those gaps. And then place a 3x3 of normal pistons, as you can see here. Now let's go to the left side. Here we start with some wire on this block. Then we need to go tighten it down with 2 lowered blocks there. Put first a 1 tick and then a 4 tick repeater. Run this again into a sticky piston with a block on top, another lowered block then. Take an output with a 4-tick repeater, run this into a full block, lowered block around the corner, so you can see it's pretty much symmetrical from here on. So another 3 lowered blocks, for redstone wire. Then we have our 3 and another 3 observers running into the 3 rows of normal blocks here with 2-tick repeaters in between. Then we need again a 3x3 of normal pistons. And now we need to fill in the blocks. And since we have a block already placed, we need to do this properly. So the simplest way is to just flick the lever once. And you can see one side has extended. On the other side, you can now place for starters just a 3x3 of normal blocks. It's important that this middle block of this 3x3 is a full block. And then place a donut on top of the gap. And with that, we should be able to see if everything works properly. Okay, that's looking good. Now the last part obviously is replacing the donut with something that makes more sense. And here we go. So now it should be pretty obvious when the blocks get swapped out. And as you can see, I also went ahead and already filled in the rest of the floor. With that done, the build is completely finished, which means this is the end of this tutorial for my simple 3x3 donut pop-up floor block swapper. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya.